he was offering wisdom, and he was offering what I think probably is similar to today with our change-up in our foods. You think about this. Think of all the foods that are right now have estrogen in them, and how the estrogen is making young girls mature very fast, and that in that maturity brings the sexual cravings. So if you look at that, you cannot say that there's not a parallel there.
Right.
Because if that's what Satan's doing in the Garden of Eden, then what I believe we're living in end times, and he's going to use again either the food, and unfortunately with our modified foods, all the things that's in our foods.
Absolutely.
He is preparing us pharmaceutically.
The vaccines.
That's right. To either be taken advantage of.
Possessed.
Exactly.
Easily.
And when I look at this, I can't say that this could not be what happened in the Garden of Eden, because again, I think the Bible verifies this stuff, and I will always believe from all my research for so many years, because I started doing this alpha and omega beginning end research back when I was in college, and we're talking about in the early 80s. That I was already writing these things. So as I've studied and studied, I've just seen too many parallels between all these things that happened throughout the history of the Bible. So we were talking earlier about Noah, but we're also seeing that it also lends itself to the end of time, back to Noah, back to the Garden of Eden. They all are tied together in the same manner. And so I do think that something happened, it changed us, but it also allowed something to take place that God had not intended to take place.
Right.
And that was that mixing between Adam, Eve, and the serpent. And if we go on and we look in chapter 3, then of course we know that, which I'd always thought, and I laugh about this all the time because I hear all these jokes about it was the woman's fault.
Right.
Well, if you read the book, and I encourage everybody to read this, it says that she took of the fruit thereof and did eat, and gave it also unto her husband, who was with her. He was not back at the cave with his feet propped up watching TV. He was there with her. So that is why God has always made the woman respond to the man, and for the man to be over the woman and be responsible in marriage or whatever. He totally tells us in marriage that the man is the head of household. So, you know, Satan couldn't have been put back if Adam had stood up, because he was with Eve and said, I rebuke you, I have power over you, but he did not do it. He allowed what happened to happen. So all those guys out there is always blamed your wife because of Eve, you can't do that anymore. It really was a joint effort that God had given Adam power to rebuke the serpent. He did not do it. He allowed his wife to fall victim to this, and then he partook immediately as her husband with her. And he did eat.
I'm going to bring out one point here, Dr. Joye, before continuing on. Just so people know, there's a scripture, I don't remember exactly where it is, but it talks about the putting on the veil. And I read in older versions how the reason that they told the men to keep the women covered with the veil was not to hide them from other humans, it was to hide them from the watchers who were lusting after the daughters of men.
That's right, and it was to keep them in a virgin state, undefiled.
That's why he charged the patriarchs to watch over the women.
And that is one of the reasons that we go back and again, it is a parallel. Where Noah was born, and there was a concern, you know, from Noah's father, Lamar, whether he was really his own son, or if a watcher had had a relationship with his wife, because Noah was somewhat unusual.
Bright nature.
Very, very bright nature. And then we know that even Joseph, when he found out that Mary was pregnant, he was like, my goodness, have you been with another man? And he blamed himself that he had done wrong by not overseeing her and making sure that nothing would come to pass and mess up their, becoming married and her being a virgin at their marriage. So
he also said in that particular story, did the same thing that happened to Adam also happen to me? In that Joseph, and this is from the Protoevangelion of James, which is an actual biblical text, chapter 6. But in that particular, and I've got that story here, we'll read it later. But in that particular story, Joseph is talking about how he comes and finds Mary pregnant, and then he asks, did not the same thing happen to me that happened to Adam? Meaning that Adam also found his wife pregnant with Cain.
And I think that's really important. And I think that there again, there is the parallels that we're talking about. From there to Noah, to the birth of Jesus, and also what will happen at the end of time. In that there will come a person who will claim to be Jesus and will be born under certain circumstances. And so we know that this is how Satan will manifest himself, and it's so important that we understand that this was going on in the Garden of Eden. Right there, plain, black and white. There's no way to get around it. There was something that happened right there. And when they had their eyes both open, they knew that they were naked.
It clicks for you, it will unlock everything else. Because that's the way it has been for both Dr. Joye and I. It's like the skeleton key to unlock all the doors.
Yes, it is. And I think that's the thing that really made me aware that that is tied beginning to end, first and last. That's why this is so important.